Hello, everybody. As you come in, let me get started again. As you come in this afternoon, go ahead and say hello. Let us know where you're watching from. We're just going to do checking the sound and everything here right now to make sure everything's working. Hopefully it is, but with technology, you just never know. So we always try to check it. No, I'm getting the thumbs up. Looks like we do have sound today. Hopefully it's clear sound. I know we had some issues last time. So we're continuing work on this chaise. We'll wait a few minutes to get started for more people to come in. But welcome to our Wednesday's Facebook Live. This is episode number 38, where we're working on this chaise. We started last week, and I did a couple little things without you guys here just to kind of get a little bit ahead. So I'll show you what I've done already. But we're going to continue on with this chaise until it is done, which will take a few more weeks. Next week, we actually won't be here live because we will be in Tennessee. So we will have to take a week off from the chaise, but maybe we'll go live from Tennessee on Wednesday. You never know. We could do that. It just depends on what's happening. So, as I mentioned, as you come in, go ahead and say hello. Let us know that you're here. Sometimes we can see that there's a number of people watching, but we don't know who you are until you say hi to us. So go ahead and let us know that you are here. I've got my tools all set. We've got the fun plaid fabric, which was the first one we put on here. And I know you'd seen the floral that I'm using for the inside, but I decided to have a different little pop on the outside back. So I'll show you that in a few minutes. Hello, Kevin, and hello, Lori. Thanks for coming and joining us today and taking time out of your busy schedules. We have been crazy busy here trying to get ready to head out to Tennessee on Sunday for the conference, and we've also got something going on Saturday that was something that was supposed to happen earlier in the month, and they had to reschedule due to snow. So we're going to have a busy, busy weekend. Yeah, it's called PodCamp. So what PodCamp is it's an on-conference conference, and it's just kind of everybody that comes in that wants to learn techie stuff and video stuff and social media things. And so everybody has, they have a board that they kind of post tags on, so you have like your wish list of things you'd like to learn. And a lot of people that are there can teach some of the subjects so that they're prepared to teach certain subjects. So if there's a call for it, they'll put their name on a tag and then they start filling in the slots. It's held at the Holyoke Community College in the Kittredge Center. And we go every year. Last year, I think we had to miss because we were out of town when they had it. But we've been going for
We were
4 years.
in Florida. That was terrible, huh?
I know we were in Florida instead of attending last year. What a bummer, huh? But this is our will be our fourth or third year, Bill,
I think
attending.
it's our fourth.
Yeah, I think this is our fourth year attending, and we get a lot out of it. It's a lot of fun. So if there's ever a pod camp near you, it's something worth checking out. This is the Western Mass pod camp that we go to. But so it's been a couple minutes. I'll get started here. But again, let us know when you're here, what you're, where you're from, and just say hello so that we know you're watching us. Give us the thumbs up and the hearts if you like what we're doing here during the episodes. Hello, Krista. Thanks for joining us. And hello, Joanne and Annette and Joe. This looks like you're all popping in rapidly now. So let's get started. So last week we had padded the deck area. I attached the deck and we padded it with two, I think it was two layers of cotton. After we went off camera, I did add the layer of Dacron just so that it wouldn't take so much more time and you'd get to see more in a week. So here you can see that I've got the Dacron on the edge right over the top of the cotton. And I did actually go around here because the Dacron wanted to pop up and spring out of the way. So what I did is I took a just the 69 bonded nylon thread that I use when I'm sewing upholstery, and I actually did a whip stitch and hand stitched it to the seam allowance of the deck fabric all the way around just to hold it down for myself from popping up. And then I stapled it down at the bottom underneath the edge roll. So we'll go ahead now and we'll start attaching the fabric. I'm really excited about this piece. It's going to be so much fun. So I'm going to go ahead and get a couple staples in the center and the front, and then I'm going to come around to the sides and pull it to keep this print going straight. So let me go ahead and get started over there. And I'm using my 3/8 inch staples for this. And I have my center marks here, which I know you can't see, but. Okay, so Bill's showing you now a picture of what this looked like before when we got it. It was a damask fabric. It was in pretty rough shape. I think I'll need a couple here just because. There, so now I'll go over to this side and I'm going to go ahead and just work it towards myself here. So I do want to keep this plait as straight as possible, although it looks like it's going to be a little bit of an angle when you look at the top. But when you see the sides will be up, straight up and down. Let's get my hose untangled. And I'm going to go ahead and get a couple staples down here, just on the side by the decorative wood here. And again, the outsides will go straight, even though from the top you see a little bit of an angle happening. When the cushion's on it, you won't see that part. All right, so now let's go get one on this side. And that way then I can work my way towards the sides. Okay, so now I will go ahead and go this way first, towards the wall, if I don't fall over kneeling. That's one thing with upholstery, you're up and down and up and down. So what's everybody out there working on in your workrooms? Into the decorative wood there, and I did. I thought so. As soon as I did it, I realized what I did. There's two little grooves, and I hit the wrong one. So that means I get a little ding in the wood to fix, but that's okay. That's one thing when you're working with these decorative woods that are there, oftentimes you'll end up having a situation where you bump it at one time or another. Oops. Pull this towards me a little bit. Tell you, these rubber mats that you have, we have around this, save your knees when you have to be down on the ground. Here it has a little detail where it goes down and then back up again, so I gotta really pay attention. And follow up around that decorative detail on the legs. And I think I might have gone into the wood again. Yep, I did. So let me pop that staple because I did hit the decorative wood again with one. Squeaky staple. In most cases, you can feel the decorative wood bumping up the edge of your staple gun, you know, the nose of your staple gun. But this is it's got a couple areas here where there's a couple little details, and it's easy to miss which one you're aiming for. And it also, like I said, isn't straight. It's wavy. Just planning my attack here, feeling what the next groove is. I'm getting in the groove today. Just continuing around. This is kind of a boring part because it's just same thing over and over here till I get down here. Then we have to make a cut to get around that arm post. Whoops, dropped my staple gun. My staple guns get dropped a lot. You're working and you're moving along. So is anybody sharing what they're working on?
Well, let's see. First off, Beth says hi. Joe Kluzniak's hi from UK. Lenny Schuster, hello from North Huntington, Pennsylvania. Trisha says hi. Kevin Tice is working on a pool deck cushions. Joanne wants to know if anyone lost audio. I don't think we did. And Krista just finished a king size headboard and bed skirt. And she signed on for Donna's video.
So we got bed skirts, headboards, deck cushions.
Beth is working on a big old sofa. Krypton fabric, good choice.
So that nobody spills beer on it, I see it, she said.
Joe's working on a wing back. Heather, let's see, what's happening here for a while? She's on the headboard, chairs. Be tough to chairs to reupholster.
You guys will have to share pictures. Sound like some fun projects. All right, now let's go ahead and get the other side to the same point before we make any of the cuts. I gotta go back towards the front, don't I? Didn't go around the corner yet. So Bill says you can't see me right now. I'm in the front of the chaise, just working around that other front corner. You should be able to see me in a few minutes when I get, or a minute here when I get around the edge. And that time I didn't hit the decorative wood on the leg on this side, which was nice. And this is where it could, because I'm going to go back later and cut this with a razor blade, you do get your staples one right after the other. I'm also watching the top of this as I go to try to keep the same consistency. And I'm out of ammo. Time for more staples. I've never sat down and paid attention to how many strips of staples I use in a piece of furniture, but I had somebody call the other day who's just getting started, and they wanted to know how many boxes of staples they should have on hand for a project. They were thinking 10,000 sounded like a lot in a box, so that they might only need one box. And I really couldn't answer, because I've never really paid attention to that. So thank you, Seal, for sharing our live feed. And if anybody else would like to go ahead and hit that share button, we appreciate it. Yeah, there it is.
So Lori's working on an old channel back doing the teardown. She says it's pretty gross.
A teardown can sure be nasty. Poor Bill gets to do that part.
I'm the stripper.
Bill's my stripper. He's the upholstery stripper. There's the... Saddling up for the weekend? Actually, I've got my outfit made or tweaked. I embellished an outfit for the Rhinestone and Cowboy Shindig. I've still got to add some details to my hat. I have a staple over there that I need to pull. So let me get my pullers, because it didn't go in all the way. So let me fix that before we go to the backside and make some cuts. Now if I can find it again, there it is. I think I got one spot a little loose. I'll adjust that later. There. Okay, where did I pull it out from? There we go. All right, now let's go back over here. And I'll be standing up for a while now. All right, so now what I need to do is I need to make a cut to get this around there. And I didn't leave myself very much unstapled, so I'm going to have to come at this from a funky angle. But because it's a plaid, it's easy to see, so I can do that. Okay, so if I come in from this line, where's my chalk here? Make myself a mark. Push this down in there. Okay. So I got my marks made. So thank you, Trisha, for sharing. See how that works, if I need to go a little deeper or not. Actually, I think this side needs to go here. And then I'm going to add a little bit of padding underneath here, which I knew I was probably going to have to do. Go ahead and get this stapled down. Got a random thread here somehow attached to the frame. be a buried staple in there that I can't see. Alright, I know you can't see what I'm doing right now, but I'm just getting this stapled around this front of the iron. And then this part over here gets all hidden from the outside back and inside back fabric later. So I'm just going to surface staple that, but before I do that, I'm going to go grab a little bit of Dacron. So I'm going to go off camera here for a second and grab my piece of loose Dacron. And that way I can stick it in that little void that I have there. And might as well bring our cotton over that we're going to need for later while I was there. I'm just using some loose Dacron for this area here because it won't form a lump, which we do not want. No lumps. There. And then later, I think what I will do is hand stitch this down on the backside just to kind of keep it taut. Now I can go ahead and do the same thing to the other side, and then we're ready to start the outside back. Let me grab my piece of chalk. Here it is. Go over there. Thanks, Joan, for sharing. I see you say you shared it when you first came in. We appreciate that. All right, so again, I'm gonna push it down in there. Mark with the chalk. And this was the side that had that funky spring that sticks up pretty high. There. And right on the side. Alright, now I make my cut. And this is a situation where my depths are not the same because of the angle here. Dacron back up in there. So this is the area that I was doing on the other side when you couldn't see me. Let me go ahead and get some loose Dacron in here. It just levels that out nicely. Regulator and tuck that little tail down there. And there we go. Our deck is done. That wasn't too bad. There. No matter how much you clean up fuzzes when you're working on this stuff, there's always threads and fuzz everywhere. I'm sure you know the feeling. All right, so the next thing I need to do is the outside back for the backs. So Trisha says, I tore down an ottoman so far, but I have it on hold because I'm refinishing my dining room table. Oh, that's a fun project. I've refinished dining room tables before for us, and that's a lot of work. Sandra says, we need you to come to North Carolina for a slipcover class. How many do we need for a class? To hold a slipcover class, we need 6 people, counting including you, Sandra, so we would only need 5 others to do that, and we can definitely pick a date and do that, and maybe even squeeze it in this year. Who knows? The schedule's not busy enough yet, right? Actually going to Pennsylvania twice this year, so that's going to be fun. Both for upholstery workshops. So, all right, so these are, which camera am I on, Bill? That one? Okay. So this is the outside back fabric that I decided to use. So it's just a fun big floral print. And I've actually marked with pins, I don't know if you can see that, probably not, let me walk up. I've actually marked the center of the whole design here with a pin. So even though you'd think like you'd want to center just the flower, that really leaves the stems looking awkward. So I centered it from top to bottom and left to right. And that is my actual center point right there with the pins in the design. So let's go ahead and get that on. So when you're doing this, you're working from the inside because there's no attachment on the outside of this frame on the back part. But when you get to the arms, it is attached from the outside. So I am going to get this up here. And I did mark my center points top to bottom and left to right on the fabric cut as well, so that I can try to line it up. So I'm just looking to see if it's gonna land the way I want it to. And it's awkward to hang on to. Okay, that part looks good top to bottom. I like that. So left to right, let's see. I mean, left to right looks good, so I gotta see top to bottom. So if I get this up here. So I can tell I'm not holding it straight by looking at the pattern, so I just gotta kinda tweak it a little bit at a time. That's pretty close, pull that down. I think that's gonna work. So let's go ahead and get a temporary staple up here in the top. And I'm gonna get a temporary staple at the bottom. I don't wanna pull it too much left or right, but I do wanna make sure that center is there. All right, so now let's smooth it out. Then I will go to the back and take another look before I go ahead and staple any more. Now we had, this reminds me of a story. We had a woman, young girl, working for us at one point in time, and she was doing a picture back chair for us. And so I helped her get it started centering it and then came back a few minutes later and she had stapled the whole thing on and it was askew. So this is one, and she had to take all those staples out, and it was kind of this type of a situation, only it was the inside, only it was the inside back. So, and right now you can see that this one's a little askew, so I need to switch it, but it's like, get a few staples, check it, and then fill it in, because there's nothing worse than thinking you've got it right and getting it all stapled down and realizing now you gotta take it all apart. So you probably can't see what I'm looking at on the camera, but I can see a little bit of a pink of the flower up here, and I can tell by the way the leaf's hitting that it needs to go that way, just a hair, not much at all. In fact, actually, I think the top needs to go. Maybe not, let me see. I know they're not gonna show exactly the same because they're on opposite sides of the stems, but I still think it needs to go just a hair. If I look at the grain, yes, I think I gotta drop this side down, which means I'll move the bottom, I guess. That will do it, hopefully. So it just has to be pleasing from all directions. So even though I've got my centers marked, sometimes your centers aren't exactly what's gonna do it to get the print to look the way you want, so. Don't limit yourself by thinking just because that's the center that you don't need to shift it to make it work. So before I get that staple back in there, let's look at it one more time here. Let me get a soft cloth tape measure. Nothing like being a little too anal, is there? Okay, so it is exactly center, but do I like it? I'm trying to decide if I like... Is the camera on behind me, Bill? So what I'm trying to decide is if I like the fact that there's so much flower showing there and not as much showing on that side. And it's one of those that's kind of a personal taste because the flower is centered left to right. And 21, 11 and a half. And it is centered top to bottom. So I've just got to decide if I like a lot more showing on one side than the other, or do I want to tweak it a little bit and then it'll be askew, but...
Well, let's see.
What's anybody else's feeling on there?
So ask the question again.
So what? Okay, so what my question is, let me smooth it back out because I messed it up a little bit here. Oops. So what my question is I'm trying to decide here at the bottom. So I've got this flower, the main flower, centered. But if you look over here, I've got just a small portion of the next flower showing, whereas on this side, I have a larger portion. And I'm just trying to decide if that bothers me or not. This is centered, so in order to accomplish them being more equal, I have to put it off center. So which is more important, having it centered or having equal amounts of pink flower show? So give me your opinion and let me know what you think here in the comments. And if I'm just being too anal, tell me that too. And then at the top, too, I've got a little bit of the pink flower on this showing and none of the pink flower from the other one, but that doesn't bother me. I'm just
okay,
trying to
Joe
decide.
Likes
so
where it is.
Okay.
Likes it like that.
There.
That says centered. And let's see.
Keep
sure
it centered.
Joe, keep it centered.
All right, so we'll leave it. Everybody seems to be okay with it like that, so we'll go ahead and we'll leave it. There's going to be so much going up on this chair anyway with all the patterns that I've chosen that it's going to be really fun. So let me get a couple of staples across the bottom. And then a couple of staples across the top here. Is that tight enough here? Let's see. I think I'll get one over here first. And I'm trying to keep the curve of the chair too. So a lot of things you're paying attention to at this point. And it's really easy to get it out of whack. See if I can staple left-handed. Okay. So next week, I think I already mentioned in the beginning, but whoops, as I pushed my chaise out of the way. Actually, let me go around the other side. So next week, we won't be here live because we will be in Tennessee still. We leave for Tennessee on Sunday to teach at the Custom Workroom Conference. And then we'll be there through Thursday. We actually decided to stay one day after the conference just to have an unwind time. So we won't be getting back to this chaise until the following week. Just watching my curve here. This is definitely an awkward angle to get everything attached and keep it taut. So did you see, speaking of workshops that Sandra brought up, did you see the video we did, I forget which day it went out this week, maybe Monday, of all the different places we're going to be this year for the workshop? Most of them are here. But we've got a lot of workshops scheduled, so we're going to have a lot of fun. And I've got a waiting list for workshops for people in this area. Oops, get myself untangled. So there we go. Yeah, we hadn't scheduled them before that because we wanted to wait until the purchase of the building was complete, which we did do that, and we closed on it on April 14th, which was awesome. So once we closed on it, then we were ready to start scheduling the workshops. I didn't want to jinx myself and have something happen. You know how that is. It's like we wanted our offer to be accepted and everything to go smooth. So now we have scheduled all those workshops, and my waiting list people will start filling in those spots for sure. Oops, it's a saw outside. All of a sudden I heard that funny noise. So we're excited about that. And the one other workshop we're working on in Pennsylvania is going to be an all-inclusive. So I'd like you guys' feedback on that. Do you like events where it's all-inclusive and you don't have to worry about your lodging and your food? Or would you rather attend something and be able to pick your own housing and lodging and food and not have it all-inclusive? So let me know. It's works out to actually be cheaper with the all-inclusive than if you scheduled your own hotel and paid for your own food separately. It's going to be at a... It's a Christian center. I forget what the name of it is right now off the top of my head, but it's in Easton, Pennsylvania. This is the woman who is hosting it, and I went back and forth on trying to decide which way to do, whether to do it all-inclusive, and we decided to give it a try and see what people thought.
And that says yes.
Yes to all-inclusive?
I think that's what it is, yeah.
So, and actually this woman owns a... Annie Sloan Paint. She's an Annie Sloan Paint stockist, and she owns a little store called Pippi and Peanuts. So you can go check her out on Facebook. Actually, she has a Facebook page and she has her website. So the day before the workshop, because people typically come in the night before so that you're there ready to go at 8 o'clock in the morning the next day. So she's doing a little meet and greet in her store for all of us the day before. So that'll be fun. It's a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday is the workshop, and then we'll meet at her place Monday afternoon. Get to know each other, and we might even have a cookout on the grill. We're still working out the details. Okay, back to the left-hand staple gun. So I'm trying to pull it tight enough to keep it taut, but not so tight that I lose the curve. So I got a few more staples to add, but let me go back and look at it from the back just because. That's so cute. I love these bright colors. Life is too short to not be surrounded by color and happy things, you know? It's funny because I had this fabric laying around for a while. I had bought some of it. I think it's a discontinued print. And I had bought some of it when I was taking one of Penny Bruce's classes. Uh-oh, Bill's playing with fabric. Bill's got himself wrapped in plaid fabric over here. He's going to be wrapped in bright and cheery. But I had taken one of Penny Bruce's classes on pleating to the pattern, and this was the fabric I bought for that class because I thought it made a really great sample. And I had bought some extra, and it's been laying around. And when I picked out the others for this, I happened to walk by the roll and went, that will be perfect as an accent on the back. So, and it has, this plaid has the red in it, which is not in the other floral. And then this floral has the red and all the shades of pink, as well as the same green as in all three fabrics. So that'll be fun. What Bill doesn't know is this is going to be the color of our bedroom. He's peeking up going, what? You like a happy, cheery bedroom, right, hon?
Yeah, whatever. All I think good about it is I know it'll change in another month or two.
I don't know if you heard him, but he said the only thing good about it is he knows it'll change frequently. He said in another month or two. Not quite that soon, but... one staple there that I need to adjust. Whoops, that staple didn't go all the way in for some reason. Must have been the way. Oh, you know what? That's my temporary staple. That's what that was. It's not the one I just shot in. There's definitely some awkward angles on this piece. Gonna make sure you get everything in the right places here. Now this is not our support system for our inside back. We still need to go over the top of this with a sagless to give it the strength. Now, as I was tightening it up, I've got a couple spots that were our original staples that I can see where I need to adjust them. So I'll go ahead and do that. You probably can't see it on camera, but let's see if I can get to a location. And I think I need to stand up on my horse a little bit. Those out without tearing my fabric. Hey, Bill, can we give them a shot of those other chairs I was working on?
These chairs over here?
Yeah. So they can see those. I haven't posted the finished pictures of those yet.
You have to hold on a second.
Looks like there's one right there. So Bill's going to move the camera so you can see. I don't know if you've been watching the chairs that I was working on that had the three fabrics, speaking of lots of fabrics. So they are finally done. Yay! So you can see, I didn't tell everybody where I was putting. Oh, they can't see it yet? He hasn't switched cameras. Silly Kim. So there, now you can see them. So they are all completed. And I started off, I think I showed on Facebook I had had the arms and the deck done and the inside back, and I was asking members of our group about the inside wings because I went back and forth on whether to do them in this rust stripe fabric or to do them in the blue, and everybody agreed that the blue, because Bill was the one that said, nah, that stripe is too much for the wing. So we did the blue and then we accented them. I think that was actually Lori, that might have been your suggestion, to accent them in the rust cording, which really worked out well. So then I wanted to have the double welt cord was all rust, so I decided to put this down here as a rust banding as well, and then box the cushion with the banding. So the pattern on the seat matches the inside back on one side of the cushion, but if you flip it over, then it matches the arms. So you've got the ability of when it's family around and you know things are going to happen that might make a mess, you have this side. And then when company comes and you want that extra pop, you flip it over and there is your white background print side. So I was really... Oh, and do you remember the little arm with the table? So this comes out and up comes our little TV tray or a writing table, and it swings. So if you're sitting in the chair and you need to get up, it just swings away from you. But when you're sitting in the chair, you can hang on to it and have whatever you need on that little table. I thought that was really cool. I would love to find a set of these. These had been in the family. I think these were the mother-in-law's, if I remember correctly. But so they've got the other chair does the same thing. This arm on that one comes out too. So those are pretty cool, though. I was happy with them when they came done. I don't know if you've ever watched Mackenzie Childs, but I love the combinations of fabrics she puts together, and that was kind of my inspiration for these pieces, and the client was willing to go for it. So what we did is we sat down and we looked at a bunch of fabrics together, and she said, I don't know which ones I want. She says, I like these colors. I like the combinations you're showing me, so you pick them out and you put them on the chair. So she has not even seen, unless of course she's watched it on Facebook, because she is on Facebook, she hasn't seen them yet or seen exactly what I ended up choosing out of the group of fabrics we had looked at. So I'm excited to get these to her so that she can see. So okay, so we are back with this camera. All right, where were we? What were we doing? Oh yeah, I gotta pop a couple staples still. So let me get, there's one over there. Oh, there it is. I was gonna say, I thought there was one more over here. And I don't wanna go that direction because if I try to take it out going this way and I slip, I might put a hole in this, and why do that? So I'm gonna go this way, and that way I'm not headed towards the good part of my fabric. Pull that. Oh, my nose is itching today. It must be allergies. Let's see. Okay, there it is. Seems like there was another spot on this side, but maybe I got them all. Right there and right there. So two more. And then I actually need to add some more staples in here. Now, if I wasn't on camera, I would probably have this on the floor. Because it is a little high for me up here. And that's, I oftentimes will put stuff like wingback chairs and things that are really high back. I put them on the floor to do parts of them just because of the height of the piece. Okay, so it's that one. Okay, where was the second one? I guess when I finished that in, it took care of that one. All right, so right there, just one more. And again, I don't want to aim towards my finished fabric. Yeah. They are pretty. Okay, so before I trim that down, I think I am going to, actually I'll cut some of this off with scissors, but then I'm gonna go over it with the sag list before I trim it all the way, and then trim it at the same time. Add a couple more staples here and there. Okay, she's looking so pretty. Being careful not to cut my deck, because that would not be fun. I guess I can trim some of this off, can't I? We'll come back with a razor blade though, and or maybe just with scissors and get in tighter. So Bill says he holds his breath when I get near the deck with the scissors, which brings up the story I'm sure you were trying to hint at. We had years ago, I was working on a sofa and I was closing up the outsides of it, and I set my scissors, some of you probably have heard this, I set my scissors on the arm of the sofa and then I bumped into it and the scissors went down and stabbed the deck and ripped the face fabric on the front of the deck. So we had to lift all the outsides back off, lift up all the insides so I could get the deck off and make a whole new deck. So I'm really careful about where I put my scissors now. So with that said, sagless. So here is, I pre-cut this already, and it looks big because that was the width on the roll, and I decided just to leave it for now. So I'm going right over the top of the fabric we already put on there, and this will be our strength. Now you could do this with jute webbing if you wanted. I prefer the sagless for a couple reasons. It's one application instead of a bunch of strips, and also it's, I lost my train of thought. Don't you hate it when that happens? Oh, it's thinner. There you go. So the jute webbing is thick and it leaves a little bit more bulk to deal with in the top areas up against your decorative wood. This is nice and thin and it doesn't do that. They do have a sagless fabric that comes in webbing strips too. I don't know if Albany carries it, but I have seen it.
You could use burlap. They have a heavier,
a nice... A sagless burlap, yeah. Yeah, which would work. But the jute webbing to me is a little bulky on these areas where you're up against the decorative wood and you don't have that much space to attach them. So that sometimes you end up seeing a little bit of a bump because of it if you can't get it back far enough on the wood. want to do when you're working around decorative wood is make sure you're not so close to the edge, and oops, that's out of staples. That's why I've got nothing happening. That your staples come out the back into the decorative wood. We've had that happen, and that's not a fun situation when that happens, because now you get a wood repair. Now that I said that, just double check myself. So far, so good. You know how when you say something sometimes, whoops, I shouldn't have gotten all those in, because now I gotta pull this tight. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna need to lower this end just a little bit. It's okay, Bill. All I was gonna do is push the horse underneath it.
You can do that yourself.
You wanna come help? You can. There's the man behind the camera.
There.
If I can do it without pulling it off the other end, that would be good. And I'm pulling it really tight with my left hand as I go here. Okay, so now let's get some awkward hose and chair combination today. Okay, hose. I don't care what you do with your hoses, they always get twisted on you. And they get caught on everything in sight. Great. So I'm pulling tight and just making sure I'm getting it to all smooth out here, which it's smoothing out really nicely, and it's still up snug against the fabric. Now, someone had posted in one of the groups recently on Facebook that they were working, that a designer that had some dining room chairs for a client. Which camera am I on, Bill? I don't know. Where am I? I'm over here. and they were, it was a picture back chair, so the outside back was upholstered from the inside just like this, but the designer wanted to add a contrast without upholstering the whole chair. So they were trying to decide how to approach it. There was conversations about trying to see if you could sneak it underneath the edge and get it glued in underneath there, but typically it's upholstered right up close to that edge, so sometimes you don't have that flexibility with the space. Like with this piece, you couldn't get something in there in most areas. There's a couple areas you could. Or just attaching it to the outside back, which makes that a permanent. Then from then on, it would have to be upholstered because you'd damage the wood. But I don't know what they decided to do. I'm just going back in and filling in everywhere. Back over the end again. This is definitely awkward because the gun doesn't want to sit right in here. There we go. Okay, get out of my face here. I can't see. Okay, now let's check around the decorative wood. Make sure I didn't come out anywhere. Nope. I still can't figure out how to hold this to make it work. The easiest. Okay, we're still good. No staples sticking where they shouldn't be. And I go add some more in here on this side and then more on the bottom. And because this is our support system, you really want it to be anchored well. Okay, on the bottom, and then we are good. Just make sure. Still good, no staples coming out where they're not supposed to. There, that is all filled in. Phew, that was a lot of work. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and trim it down and then I'll fold it over and staple it on top of itself. So for those of you, it looks like we're getting close to 1:30 already. I thought I had to get further today. So for those of you that are part of our Kim's DIY Upholstery Hangout, for the members and people that have taken the workshops, we will be live in the group again today at 3 o'clock, and we're gonna try the blue jeans. We're gonna try the blue jeans platform again and hope that some of you will be able to come in with us. So Bill will post the link to the blue jeans meeting, and what you need when they ask for the member for the group ID number, I think it is, when you get in there, sometimes is the digits on the end of that URL. So all you need to do is copy and paste those digits that are there. I think it starts with a 6, and it's probably about 6 or 9 numbers. It's a long number. So we encourage you to come on in the Blue Jeans platform with us so that you can chat face to face. That's where we all show up on camera, kind of like the Brady Bunch. You know, you get all the pictures of people side by side. So at 3 o'clock, we will be there in the group. I've gone through and tagged some of the questions in the group that I'm going to be talking about in the live this afternoon. But we encourage you, while we are live, to go ahead and bring some more questions with you. And we usually have time for that. So we will be doing that this afternoon. Let me go finish getting this trimmed. I think this would have gone quicker if it wasn't such an awkward angle to be attaching it from. You just never know. It's like yesterday, I worked all day on those chairs, and it's like I really wanted them done by the end of the day. But then I sat and looked at everything I did do, and it was like I really did get a lot done yesterday, even though it didn't feel like it at the time. Things just take time. Go ahead and trim this. All right, so it is just about 1:30, so we'll go ahead and fold this over and get it attached. So some of you I will see at CWC on Monday or Sunday night. If any of you out there watching are members of the virtual chapter too, don't forget to come to the registration area. I think registration opens at 4 o'clock on Sunday night. Don't forget to come. I'm talking to nobody. Don't forget to come to the registration area and get your blue tassel, which will designate you as a member of the virtual chapter, so that when you see somebody else walking around at CWC with a blue tassel, you'll know that they're part of the group and you can go make a friend. So for those of you that are going to be there, make sure you come. If you're not a member of the virtual chapter, make sure you come up and say hello to me so I get to see you face to face. Some of you I may recognize and some of you I might not. So come on up and introduce yourself to Bill and I. We're looking forward to it, and we will post pictures from the shindig in the conference so you can see what we're doing. So thank you everybody for taking time out of your busy days and joining us here. I'm going to go ahead and get this part finished before we meet back here in 2 weeks to do this. But we'll see you guys all later and have a great weekend. And to you members, we'll see you this afternoon in a little bit.